How to create a perfect water reflection in Photoshop. In this video, I will show you how to make water reflections from scratch with realistic reflections and ripples. I'm going to show you a couple of examples of working with ripples, and in this case, we're going to work with a reflection and ripple in water. So I have a background here. I added a boat. I cut the boat out, I have my layer mask here, and I created a smart object out of it. So now the first thing we're going to do is we're going to duplicate this layer here, my boat layer. I'm going to duplicate that with Command J, and I got rid of the layer mask of that duplicate right there. So I'm going to make a new smart object out of this layer. I'm going to make this my reflection layer. I'm going to transform this, Command T, and I want to flip it. So I'm going to right click in my transform and say flip vertical, hit my check mark, and with my move tool selected and holding the shift down, I'm going to bring this boat down to where it meets in the water right here. So now let's make that boat looks more like it belongs there in the water, and let's make that reflection looks like it belongs to that boat. So I'm going to click on the reflection layer, and I'm going to take the opacity down. Let's start it around 50%. Now I'm still in the reflection layer, and down here at the bottom of this reflection of the sail, we want to kind of make that blend in a little bit, kind of go away. So I want to give my reflection layer a layer mask. Then I'm going to hit G for the gradient tool, and I'm going to use a linear gradient, and I set my foreground color to like a gray color. Say okay. So I'm using foreground to background color for my gradient. Put my shift key and draw up, make that bottom of that kind of go away. You see how that kind of fades there? And now we want to add some ripple to our reflection. Click on the reflection thumbnail, not on the layer mask, and come up to filter, distort, and ripple. And for size, we want to try a medium, and the amount, bring it up to something around 400, and say okay. Now you see what that did, it brought in some ripples into the reflection. Come over here to our reflection layer. You see that we have a smart filter called Ripple. And if we want to change that, just double click on the name and you can change the amount or you can change the size of the ripple. You can play with that. Whatever is going to work for your image. So now we're going to blend in that reflection a little bit more. And if you notice that here, there's some ripples or little waves in the water. And these dark areas are shadows because they're facing us. So we're not going to see that reflection in those darker areas. The lighter areas are facing the boat. The darker areas in the water are facing us. So to take care of that, we're going to double click on the reflection layer. And that's going to bring up a layer style. And we're going to work with blend if down here. We're going to work with the underline layer. So we want the darker areas to show through. So if we bring over our blend if slider, you see it's how the darker areas are starting to come through. Now if I hold down Alt or Option, I can split this control and you see how that looks. I'm gonna zoom back out a little bit more and you see how this is starting to make our sail blend in a little bit more and look like a reflection. And you can adjust this to your taste, how much you want to see, but those dark areas are now coming through. And you can also do this with any highlights. If you see some of those, you want to preserve those too. And again, I'm going to split this and I'm going to say okay. So now the boat looks like it's actually in the water. It has reflection and ripples in the reflection. And here's before with no boat. Here's the boat in the water. There's the before and the after with the reflection and the ripple. And you can go back into the smart filter or the layer style and make changes. In this example, we're going to create our own reflection from scratch and we're going to add our ripples. So first thing I want to do with this image is I want to give myself some more room up here in the sky area. So I'm going to come up to my crop tool and up here at the top, I'm going to have content aware checked and delete crop pixels unchecked. And I'm just going to pull on this bar right here and give myself some room up here. I'm going to click on my check mark because I'm going to want to move these houses closer to the top here because I want more room here on the bottom for my reflection. I'm going to duplicate that layer. And now I'm going to use my marquee tool to make a selection around the part of the image that is going to be above my reflection. And I'm going to put this selection on its own layer and hit Command J. Now that selection is on its own layer. And now I want to flip this layer vertically. So I'm going to say Command T, right click and say flip vertical, Click my check mark. I'm going to change this into a smart object and rename it reflection. Now I'm going to click on my move tool, hold the shift key down, and I'm going to move my reflection down. I can also position my layer below it so it is more closer to the sky. Again, I'm holding the shift key and I'm moving up my layer, my reflection layer below. And you may need to position both the layers at the same time. So I'm going to hold down the shift key, and with my move tool selected, I'm moving both layers up at the same time. So now that these houses are the reflection of each other, if you want, you could say you're done. Now I suggest you look at a lot of photos that have reflections. There's different kinds. There's reflections where you see a still reflection, no ripples below it. And there are reflections that are really distorted as far as the reflection and the ripples. Let's get some ripples in here. With the reflection layer selected, I'm going to come up here to filter, blur, and motion blur. I'm going to set the angle to 90, distance to 11, and say okay. On the layer, if I drop this arrow down here, you can see that it is a smart filter. I can double click on motion blur, and I can change angle or distance and say okay. So now I'm going to show you two different ways to create ripples. So we're going to go to the same filter we did in the last example. So I'm going to go to filter, distort, ripple. You can go back and forth and try different size and amounts. I'm going to try medium, amount 400, and say okay. And see, that is the effect. I can double click on ripple. I could change it to large size and say okay. So medium is somewhere in the middle. So for this image, it's more of a subtle ripple. And if you don't like this effect, I have another one for you. And we're going to create a ripple displacement map. So for right now, I'm going to disable this ripple filter. To create our displacement map for our ripples, I'm going to come up here to File, New. We want a new Photoshop document here. And the size should be something that is more of a vertical document. So we want this document to be 200 width, 330 height, 72 resolution, RGB color, black background, orientation, vertical, and say create. We want to add some noise to this document. So come up here to filter, noise, add noise. I'm going to have my amount to maximum, distribution, uniform, and monochromatic checked, and say okay. I want to add a blur to this document. Come up to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. We'll make this 1.5 and say okay. And now we want to go to our channels panel. I'm going to click on the red channel and come up here to filter, stylize, emboss. I'm going to set the angle to 90 degrees, height to 1, and the amount to maximum, which in this case is 500. I'm going to say okay. I'm going to do the same thing to the green channel. I'm going to come up here to filter, stylize, emboss. This time I'm changing the angle to 180. Everything else stays the same, height 1, amount 500, and say okay. Now I'm going to click back over to my layers panel and I'll click on this lock right here so it's a layer. And now I want to change the perspective of this document. I'm going to come up here to edit, transform, and click on perspective. And I'm going to grab this bottom handle right here and I'm going to stretch this out, make it a little bit smaller so I can stretch it out more, and just stretch it out as much as you can. And I'm going to say okay. Now we need to save this document as a Photoshop file, a PSD. We'll save it on the computer. Make sure that it is PSD. If this file is too big, it will want to save it as a PSB, and the displacement map filter will not take anything but a PSD file. So now back to our image. I had disabled the ripple filter that we used before, and now I'm going to come up to filter, distort, displace. And this is where we're going to bring in our displacement map file that we created. I'm going to start out with horizontal scale of 10 and vertical scale of 40. Both of these values could be changed later so that it will change your ripple effect. You can play around with these. Stretch to fit needs to be checked. Repeat edge pixels needs to be checked. And check embed file data in smart object and say okay. And here is our displacement map file that we created. I'm going to select that and say open. And here is our ripple with the displacement map. I'll disable this and enable the ripple that we first created. You can see the difference. I'll turn this displace back on. And if you want to change this, just double click on the displace filter and you can change these values and make your ripple look different. I'm going to include the displacement map file that we created in the description, and you can download that and use that in your project. Here is our original image of the houses. And now here are your houses with your reflection and your ripple. For more Photoshop tutorials, click on one of the videos on the screen now. Please like, share, and subscribe. Remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching.